Language does not kill me, can only make me stronger. For real. I don't see why everybody feel as though they gotta tell me how to live my life. You know? Let me live, baby. Let me live.
Well, anyway, I want to thank you guys for tuning in to this week's episode of Hoshily Awkward. Did my mic just go out? I feel like it went out a little bit.
No, your head, I
turned
the headphones down.
Oh, okay. So, by the sound of my voice, you can probably tell that I'm kind of peeved. It's hot as fucking here. These lights, it's cooking me. I had to stand outside longer than I should have had to fucking stand outside. And y'all know that I'm allergic to everything outside. And on top of that, Marcus is late as usual. So, we not even going to introduce that nigga. He get here when he get here. I am joined by two of three of my co-hosts. We got Heartbreak Fresh and that other nigga. He don't get no intro today either. I'm just off everybody today. I guess I could act like I care. How was y'all weekend?
I was all right. I went to work.
I had to move my mom's to her new place.
See, I attempted to do a sibling outing, but niggas just make shit way more complicated than they fucking have to, so I just said screw it.
Damn, that was this weekend.
It was this weekend. It absolutely was. So, I don't know if y'all saw the video that I posted in a group earlier. All them niggas fighting in Miami airport, dog.
Yes, I watched a few seconds of it.
Like, you didn't watch the whole thing?
I did not.
I watched the whole thing.
So, whatever nigga was off to the side, I think he had on like a blue jacket, blue shirt, whatever. Like, they put the fops on that nigga so cold. And, I mean, y'all know how I feel about jumping people, but like, I've never seen people getting down like that and like nobody around, period, like tried to intervene, like break it up, like security wasn't even around. Like, where the fuck is TSA at this point,
bro? That's one of them,
because they got to fight for a long ass time.
They'll eventually tire themselves out. I'm not breaking that shit up.
That, but that's what I'm saying, like security wise, like, no, you know, people standing around recording with their phones and shit, but it was niggas yelling, like white people yelling back, like, stop, you're gonna kill them. Like, they was really, like, you gotta watch the whole video, dude, because the white people's reaction was everything to that shit. They was like, you're gonna get in trouble, just stop it. So, I don't know if the guy, it was a black guy at the end that finally, big black guy that finally came in the end, and he was trying to, like, break it up. I don't know if he was a civilian or what, trying to get some flight credits, but.
He said, this is going to earn me one free flight.
No, but
or he can get his flight.
But there was one kick in that fight that I felt. It was the fight over on the left-hand side. And it was a, damn near, everybody in that fight had dreads damn near. But one guy was on top of the other guy. It was a big guy. He had on white pants. And what y'all niggas call him? Y'all call him the op? He came up behind it when I say he kicked him toe first up the ass, like, bro, imagine you in the bra for your life in the middle of an airport and all of a sudden you get kicked toe first up your asshole. That shit made me clench. I saw it clench a little bit, but then I think it, like, the adrenaline wore off quick.
Well, like a tennis shoe.
Yeah.
Oh
man, toe first, nigga. So I don't know if he was trying to kick him, like, in the nuts. Because, you know, niggas wear their pants so fucking big. Can't really catch it, but he caught that nigga right smack in the ass.
That's nuts.
What is there to fight about in the airport?
I really
like
don't
knowing
know.
Like, knowing the consequences of it.
Maybe he just was a nigga who had one. Had it on site.
Hey, you gotta look at the context. Like, where is this before boarding a plane?
It had to be, bruh. We're fighting in the lobby area.
Or are we fighting at the luggage carousel?
No, it looked like.
Because niggas are stealing bags.
Yeah, it looked like it started by, like, one of the gates. But like I said, nobody else was around. So it ain't like it was a bunch of people in line. Like, they had all that open space.
Maybe it was an on-site situation.
Bro. Like, I've had,
like, them niggas been
my share of drama. I've had my share of on site. Like, I know how she be. Like, Keisha tell you, I was trying to get motherfuckers. We was finna go to, what the fuck is, I don't even remember the name of that group. It was a, damn, it ain't B2K. What the fuck group was out there?
Oh, my bad.
Yeah, you know, even with me being the first motherfucker to sling, I am not going to put myself in certain situations.
But you smart because you like to travel.
And these the airport ain't.
These
know.
Niggas might be like, well, I can drive anywhere if I
can
need
they,
to.
Or can they, like, they put your ass on a no-flight list for fighting in the airport?
Yeah. You a hazard.
That's not a federal crime, though. I mean, if I commit any crime, it would be a federal crime. I know better.
Right.
I'm not committing any state crimes.
Well,
like,
I don't know,
I go down, I'm going back to the FCI.
But they might put that as on the no-fly. Think about it, dog. If you willing to fight here in this Terminal Z, what you going to do in these rows on this plane?
But you know what? Somebody did make a good comment. That was like how at least when niggas fighting in the airport, you know it's going to be a fight and not a shootout.
That's true.
That's true.
So, like, yeah, because you know your pistol shit got to be in your check.
Maybe
baggage.
That's another reason why he squabbled on dog. Maybe he always running around with his gun. And now you go like, nigga, I know you ain't got it now. Catch these hands.
Yeah, but it was more like, it,
2020, like, catch these hands, not these flights.
Like, niggas was definitely outnumbered. But I give it to the guy that got kicked in the ass. It took them a long time to get him down.
That's probably why they kicked him in the ass.
But the other one, like, that nigga went down immediately. And they swarmed. Like, all you see it, because, like I said, he had on, like, a blue shirt. Hoodie, whatever.
Was he the first nigga they went for?
And he was, no, it, they were split up. So the guy in the blue, it was two dudes on him. And then the guy in the white, it was, I think it was like four of them all together over here. So they had two and two. They was kind of even, but somebody went down and it was just whatever. But dude over here in the blue, like, all you can see is the nigga in the red. Just all, you can't even see him no more. All you see is fucking hammer coming down. I'm like, damn, man, it's kind of fucked up.
I mean, maybe he had coming to him, bro.
So,
because I feel like if you had to get jumped in the airport, you probably had it coming. You owe back child support and niggas, whatever.
Like, now, as much as I hated to see it because, you know, it had to be us, when white people cut up in public like that, I'm like, aha, it ain't us this time. But I think even though it pissed me off, like, you niggas can't behave nowhere, it was still like, damn. I'm happy to see that niggas are actually fighting again, though. But, again, going back to that comment, they had no fucking choice.
No, they had circumstances.
Niggas ain't have a box cutter, a pocket knife, ain't have nothing.
Nigga, it's just these fisticuffs.
Hey, shout out to Keish, because she taught me a new word. Is this what a glizzy is?
A glizzy?
Your Glock?
Yes.
Yeah, so.
Oh,
he had a glizzy on it.
I was like, dog, I didn't even know what that was.
Glizzy. She made a post the other day talking about it. But no, I don't, I can't see something being that fucking important. Because if that's the case, like, if I feel
maybe
like I want to go with you in an airport.
Maybe he stole money from the crew to go to a Audi and they stopped that nigga at the airport.
Bro, you couldn't catch the nigga out by the Uber, like,
look,
by the
bro,
little
that
taxi
plane,
pickup.
That plane could have been his freedom.
Yeah.
That was for real. That plane could have been his freedom. You know, a nigga get on a flight and go to another state and don't have to come back.
Also true. You can go to another fucking country and not have to come
back.
They
not have people do it all the time.
Yeah, don't niggas look like they owe back child support.
Check,
I don't
the,
think
Cuba, check the Cuba registry.
Yeah. Shout out to my pops. I nigga went to Canada. I was like, fuck this.
Nah. I made my decision. I'ma give me a ticket, give me a room,
go to Vegas.
Take Miss Prime and go. I'm going to Vegas.
Megatron 5000.
So, you know, and I'ma buy me like the longest power strip that I can find so I can extend it to the balcony.
And you trying to be the new bad bitch on the balcony.
Hey.
Just about seven of them motherfuckers and plug them in like a caterpillar.
You know, you just go on Amazon. And just order one of them, like, 100-foot extension cords.
Man. I'm just... The only thing I don't like having to go by myself is I don't want to carry on.
I was going to say, dude, that thing looks like it's got some weight to it.
It does. But usually, like, when I'm going through, like...
Withdrawal?
No. My hotel rooms. You know what pisses me off? Because I get rooms a lot.
Same crack, though.
When I get my rooms and I don't take Coctomus Prime with me,
it's boring.
No. I get rooms like boom, soon as I check in. Oh, well, you know, first floor right around the corner, whatever. You know, like it's close to the elevator.
Right.
Soon as I got that heavy bitch with me, it never fails. They put me all the fucking way on the end
you
of the
know
hotel.
Because they see that bitch in your suitcase. It's like,
they
you
don't
know
what that is.
She
they can't
some
tell.
Privacy.
They can't tell.
She's about to tear herself down.
But it never fails. Whenever I got to carry that heavy motherfucker with me, I'm always in like the furthest room from an elevator. But what I do anyway, like, because I have my big rolling suitcase with me, like, I set it on top of that and I kind of tilt it a little bit and then I just drag it and I just pull it. I mean, it's still heavy, but at least I don't have to physically fucking carry it. I still just roll it.
Okay.
I'm so, starting asking for one of them little, you know, them big ass bellhop carts.
Right.
They got,
I was going to say the cart.
Just start putting that motherfucker on there.
When you get on
the
plane and they get your luggage, you got to check your luggage in and it scans, right? And they see, because they going to see Coctomus Prime in the scan, right?
Yeah, I mean,
and they're gonna see the dildo attachments to the side of it.
Yeah, because when it is broken apart, it looked like a little exercise bike.
But
the dildo attachment will be in the bag.
Right, like the dildo attachment is gonna give it away.
Yeah.
So they're gonna be like, "Excuse me, ma'am."
I'm like, "What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas." So mind your fucking.
You know,
business.
She might get lucky, and there might be a woman. It's gonna be a black woman. Talking, you have you some fun, girl. You know, them sassy black TSA women are.
I've never met a sassy black. That sounds stereotypical as fuck.
You know why Soul Plane?
That movie's a big ass stereotype.
It was made by black people. What do you expect?
I know. Speaking of stereotypes, did y'all see the post I shared earlier?
Which one?
Where they was going back and forth, ribbing based off of stereotypes and shit. The black and the white dude.
No, but I've done that before.
Yeah, it was.
I sat at UWM and did that for about like 20 minutes with a couple of people.
Let me see if I can.
And then we ganged up on the
Asians.
I
didn't really post that much today. I was busy as fuck at work today. I didn't like it.
# stop Asian hate.
I didn't like it.
It was in the early 90s. It was allowed.
Yeah, so it said, this is the best racism war in the history of Twitter. So the black dude said, imagine having to wear sunscreen. But we got to wear that shit too. I know a lot of you black people may not be aware, but we do sunburn. So don't let that hype fool you.
It just takes us a while for it to show up.
You know, we get fucked up too. but the white dude said, imagine having to travel for clean water. Black Point. Dude, imagine being genetically predestined to have a small willy. The white dude said, imagine having a life expectancy of less than 30.
Point.
Hey, the white dude was throwing some zingers.
Well, he keeps saying point.
Yeah, he told the white dude, said, imagine the spiciest food you can tolerate being salt.
Point.
Imagine the best footwear in your village being a pair of sandals.
I kind of don't want to give a point.
Hey, now the black dude, which is kind of, I don't think he realized how much that really stings our community too. Because he said, imagine being genetically predisposed to start balding at 25.
I got a crew.
A whole crew.
Juan, ain't me and you the only one?
What the fuck is Man United?
Wasn't that the black group that sung You Should Know on Panther?
I don't know.
I don't think so, man.
I think it was. It's a man or men?
No, say Man United.
Hey, Google that.
He said, imagine your national food being mashed potatoes and vegetables. And then the white dude said, imagine dreaming about eating mashed potatoes and vegetables for once instead of golden rice.
Shit. This white dude's on point. I gotta give him.
Hey, man. He said, imagine having no sense of rhythm. He said, imagine your sense of rhythm originating from working on a cotton field.
Yeah. Hit the button, one. Yeah.
Fatality.
Yeah.
That's racist as shit.
It's funny because that would have been an argument. Like, in person, it would have pissed me off. But at the same time, you dodged them some good ones.
That's fucking hilarious.
That is terrible, man. But then they They caught it, but they used a little, you know, the little spy versus spy from Mad TV, little black and white dude. But
that was fucking hilarious.
It's crazy because it's like a lot of people think like it's just, you know, black people. Still like, no, niggas stereotype everybody. Yeah, they just feel a type of way when other people do it to them. I'm like, dog, you do that shit every day.
We literally, yeah, we stereotype everybody.
Everybody.
And
every
get
day.
Mad when one gets hit on us. Because this nigga right here alone.
No, he's terrible.
Right. This he's nigga alone, terrible. Every episode, what? I gotta, absolutely. Bro, you can't say that. What you mean I can't say that?
Did we not have your kid on this same here platform?
No.
She was talking about her own community, though.
I don't.
That's acceptable.
And you were wanting to adopt an Asian baby.
I really did after watching Mortal Kombat. That little Asian baby was cute.
Oh, the one they hid in the basket?
Yep. I was like, oh, look at them cheeks. And Reed was like, dude, she was like, that baby is so fat. I said, see? Asian baby. And she was like, mom, don't
start. No. Your reasoning for wanting an Asian baby is what was wrong.
What reason was so wrong about it?
You want him to be like 12 and do your taxes.
Right.
Because he fucking capable of doing it.
Like little black kids ain't capable of doing that with the proper education.
Nah, Asian.
Yeah, but they just born knowing how.
Asians come out the womb knowing all that shit.
Yeah, just because they created the abacus doesn't mean anything.
Fried rice, roundhouse kicks, and math. That's all they need.
Chicken and collard greens. Hip hop. I got nothing after that.
We don't have start.
We probably do. I just can't think right now. We create a lot of shit, okay?
Damn, man, sports.
Yeah, sports. There we go.
It's even niggas in hockey.
I don't know why.
Niggas in hockey, niggas in basketball.
It had to be the nigga that, you know what? I am not good. I'm not tall enough for basketball. I'm
Kayla
not fast
said
enough
that Manchester
for
United is a soccer team.
Yeah,
why does Kayla know that?
Oh, because her son plays soccer.
Oh, you're right. You know what?
Dog, I'm on a diet, bro. You relax.
Kayla's Jamaican. They definitely play soccer.
Kayla's Jamaican? I never knew that.
I don't think she's Jamaican, but she just came from Jamaica.
Oh, wrong. Wrong K. My fault.
The one who was just here.
Yeah.
She's Jamaican.
Yeah. That's what I said. Wrong one. Wrong K.
Are you talking about the K-Way one?
Yeah.
No, we're talking about Kayla Howard.
Yeah, I just grasped that concept afterwards.
No, not Kayla Howard. Taylor. Sorry.
Yeah.
We're talking about Kayla Taylor. He was talking about Howard.
Yeah.
That motherfucker's delicious. I hate you for it.
Oh, God.
She got mad at me this weekend because I gave her wine.
That's how good vaginas taste. Like a mamba.
I won't argue. I've had a couple.
If your vagina not smacking like this mamba, keep that shit away from me. I'm dead ass.
I'm not disagreeing with you, bro.
Pack of mamas.
Don't need Ma here for this part anyway, because they'd be unattractive before he smashed. Like, have you ever felt like
fatality?
Like somebody has gotten unattractive, like after you smashed him, like it was just a lot of shit that you noticed after the fact. You're like, damn, was it really that weak that it just brought out all of your flaws?
Everything that you were tolerating to get to the draws, you don't have to tolerate no more because you got them. So now you start getting annoying.
Because I'm like, all right, you know, I had an attraction. Dog was, you know, he was decent. And then it's like, after I had it and it wasn't smacking like I thought it was, now I look at him and it's not the same.
Yeah, it's like women, they into the dude and then he got the small dick and then you try to have sex with him and it doesn't please you. Now everything about that nigga is no longer attractive to you.
That sounds like what happened.
Is that like the equivalent, like when you spend your money, then you get a pussy and it be weak, you be like, damn, I wasted all that money for this.
You went and took her out to get a steak and it looked like a roast beef?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. That changes the game.
I was expecting filet mignon. You showed up with London broil.
I was okay with it. Damn. Give yourself one, bro.
Fatality.
Fatality.
Oh, this is what the Death Row show used to be.
I think the funny part about that is because I went grocery shopping today and it was shaved beef. Right by the roast and shit. Oh, man. That's
shaved beef.
Yeah.
Like, you know how funny. All right,
so how do we get here, Mimi?
Well, no, because it's like you got that quality packed lunch meat where it's like neatly sliced and everything. But then you got like that Aldi shit where it's that real thin lunch meat and they just ball it up and throw it in the bag.
Just
you know
look
what
like
about?
They threw it in a little package. I mean, it's still good, but they just look like they didn't care about it. Come like, out. It gets the job done, but.
That shit come out of the meat press.
It wasn't shaved properly.
I just think it's that London bro. Jesus.
That's how I know you work at the meat section of your job.
I was at work yesterday.
I know. That's what I'm saying. That's how
we
I know.
We had some finely cut filet mignon. Then I was in the department selling roast beef. I was out here.
It looks different, don't it?
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have that same aesthetic appeal to it.
I don't even like roast beef.
Yeah, it has its days.
Well, you know, like, I have officially.
Given up meat.
No, not meat. Just I haven't had red meat in 2 weeks.
I'm proud of you.
I haven't had fried food in
two
I'm
weeks. Definitely proud of you on that.
Yep. So any chicken I've had, I made some shish kebabs on I got a Power XL indoor grill. So
yeah,
I made
you
some,
told me that's why you had to make the shish kebabs.
Yep. So I
you
made
can really live your life in a bubble.
Yeah. So I had.
I mean, she don't
shish
come
kebabs
out good.
Going on. Salad. So it's usually just grilled chicken. And a salad, but no.
You really been on your salad kick. Hey, let me ask you a question. Since you've been eating healthy and you know, stuff from the earth, you've been shitting more, haven't you?
Yes.
I don't get that.
I have.
You should have less waste in you because everything you eating is good for you.
But I've also noticed that it's a different consistency, too. Like, it's not formed. Like, it's... Like, it's messy.
Your shit look like cow shit.
You know, if you eating healthy, you need a bidet.
Need some wet wipes.
You know, my kids piss me off so bad. They have a horrible, horrible habit. Like, because we always keep wipes in the house. But they always leave the fucking pack open. And it's like, if you are just going to dry the wipes out, that defeats the purpose, and we can use tissue.
Right.
The whole purpose is for this shit to be moist so we can, you know, properly wipe things away. So that annoys me bad.
It's a moist toilet.
Yeah. But I feel like I don't feel like I miss a lot of stuff because my appetite really wasn't there like that anyway. But I thought that it would be a lot harder. We're not eating, like, because you know I love to fuck out some wings.
That's true.
But, I mean, even then, I can still do, like, even with wings. You don't have to fry wings. You can, you know, grill them, bake them, whatever.
But we like fried chicken.
Yeah, a lot. So that kind of, what? Oh.
Fried chicken.
That was kind of, I thought it was going to be a harder transition, but it wasn't at all. Yeah, you know what? Initially, it did give me more energy, but now it's kind of, I think something is going on weird with me because I've been like super, super tired. I think it's just my body is, I'm finally starting to get into a sleep schedule for work now.
About damn time.
I know, right? Been a couple months. But I have to stay up more. Because I got to, like, work now. And I'm not used to having to do that. But it's definitely I don't know. I've definitely had a lot of progress, though. Like, I'm not naive enough to feel like, oh, well, you just been losing all this fat, blah, 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 blah. I know a lot of that has been, like, with water weight and just bloating and a lot of that stuff. But because when I started, I was 174.6 when I went to the doctor. And as of last night, I was 165.2. So.
Getting your summer body ready?
Hell yeah.
So you could be out your.
Getting my summer body ready.
I feel you.
Comer Summer, ladies and gentlemen.
Nice wordplay.
Hi, too.
Hi, too.
Boom.
Yeah, I'm on that. Like, I don't know, man. I'm about to be 37 this year. And I don't want to look like the motherfuckers that's 27. Because they look horrible.
They crack the fuck out.
Woo. Oh, because dude finally showed up.
And we're off. Off to the races. Get ready. This is the whole lot of this button.
Say what?
I know it's coming.
Well, before you were so fashionably late, I asked a question.
Okay.
Like,
can y'all hear me all right?
Yeah.
All right.
Like, it's important. But has anybody, like, after you smashed them, they got unattractive to you? Like,
yeah.
Like, you they were cool beforehand, but then, like, after you had it, it was just like, mm-mm.
It, you know what? It don't be as good as you think it's going to be. And then you went through all that fake listening and caring.
Just dude, y'all really pieces of shit, because that's pretty much the answer tone guy.
Just for some some mediocre ass, like.
I mean, it's the truth.
Yeah, like, you went through all that talking and texting and, like, how was your day? And then you listening to some shit that you don't give a fuck about because you tired. Like, you responding quick. You know, you answering sometimes when they call.
I just
to get the bitch and she get up there scooting, or she got the turtle back when you finally get it.
I'm mad because I pictured the turtle back.
Right, you hear me?
I knew exactly what he was talking about when he said it.
So then after you get it, you like,
serve a hunchback puzzle.
This was it. I didn't see no sparks, no unicorns, no nothing. Like, this was, I could have jacked off.
I could have had a V8.
And I think, like with who it was, I expected, like, some MK fatality fucking.
Did he promise you MK?
Yes.
They it never.
And anybody it didn't go that way. So now them. I don't look at people as well. It's like, you know.
He hit you with a friendship.
It was
fatality. Friendship.
I don't know what he hit me with, but it wasn't hard enough.
We got to get the rest of them on this board, too.
Yeah.
Nigga, so. I got to go find a game to make it say those.
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of bitches have become unattractive to me after I smash. And then, more than likely, I either block them or I just start to wean them off. Like, don't respond as fast no more. Or if they text good
morning. I definitely stop. Like,
if they text good morning, like that, you like, leave it delivered for 3 days and then be like, I just seen this.
Shit.
Yeah, I don't, man. And it sucks because, like I said, you know, I had an initial attraction. I said delivered. But it's just, it's like, gone.
I can see that. Treat them like that friend request.
I'll give you an example.
I think because Teresa got turned me off.
You know what? That usually be the case.
I'll give you an example. A bitch from out of town, she was real good with angles. This bitch was like a magician. She was hiding half her body out the picture.
Half, nigga?
Yeah, at least half. Half that motherfucker out the picture. Oh, my. So, you know, we talked for a little bit, and she flew up here.
Two seats.
I get to
fatality.
It.
I get to it.
So she flies up here.
And, jumbo plane.
I think I was. Wait, what?
Jumbo plane. Remember the Fisher Price jumbo plane toys, bro.
So. I think
he tried to slide it in there, dog.
Yeah, I heard it, but I didn't hear it. So, can I tell a story, dude? Damn, man, your fat ass. So she flies up here, or whatever, and I think I'm in the middle. I was in the middle of working, so she just happened to be staying near one of my stores. So I'm like,
hey, hold on, real quick. Did you log in from my page? I forgot to ask you that.
Yeah, you should be. Oh shit, it didn't go to your page.
This nigga.
So, no, because I was scrolling my page looking for something else and I didn't see it on there.
Yeah, I sent them to both of the Hopefully Opera page and I forgot to click yours.
So, you know, she like, tell me where she's staying. I'm like, okay, that's cool. That's by one of my stores. I'll stop and see you or whatever. So I stop and I go in the room or whatever. Her friend is there. She's sitting down. Her friend is standing up laughing and talking. So I sit down. I can't really get the whole thing because she's sitting down. I can't really see what's going on. And I didn't want to stare too much. So I kind of like gave her the look like, get your friend up out of here. I am on the clock. So her friend leave and then she stand up. And I was like, oh, wow. You got me.
Better watch out quick. Fucking man, with heavyweight.
You hear me? Heavyweight like a motherfucker. So
jumbo plane.
She get the squeezing on my Charlie and shit. So I'm like, alright, well I'm here now, I might as well smash. So as I'm smashing, I'm like, this coochie not even good. She's screaming and hollering and carrying on, but in my head I'm like, this ain't good. Like, I'm not enjoying this. So about, I want to say like 5 minutes into it, because I had been looking at my phone, I knew I had to get back to work. About 5 minutes into it, I faked a nut real quick. You know, jumped off of her, tied it, and I threw it in the toilet. Like, I nutted. I'm like, made the noise and everything. So she like, it must have been good. I'm like, mm-hmm. So I'm putting my shit back on. I take a whole bath, put my shit back on. I don't want to go back to work smelling like rubber and fat sex. So.
Fatality.
What is wrong with y'all, man?
You gotta go, dog.
Can I finish the story, dog?
No!
That better not be the title of this fucking episode. I know that shit.
No guarantee. No guarantee.
Top of the list now. It's definitely top of the list.
Why? Let me finish, bro. It ain't that much more to the story. So, then I take a whole bath, whatever, put my shit back on. I get ready to just walk out. I didn't forget this bitch is even in the room. Like, I'm trying to get the fuck out of here. She said, damn, no hug. And I'm like, oh, my bad, G. So I gave her a little half church hug, and I walked out. She like, you going to come back later? I'm like, yeah. So later on that night, she texts like, what you doing? I said, I got a family issue. I ain't going to make it back. And she was like, well, you know we leave tomorrow. I said, I'm going to try to see you before you leave. I knew I wasn't, though. I knew I was done when I walked out the door. So the next morning she texts like, we flying back. I said, safe trip. So then a few days go by, she texting good morning every day. I ain't responding to none of that shit. So then after a week, she was like, you acting funny. I'm like, oh. I'm like, I tend to do that. I said, we probably shouldn't even talk no more. And then like after that, like, I just end up blocking her anyway. That's where the fuck them block came from, the stat I made that time. Like, and she actually had the nerve to tell motherfuckers about this experience too, which pissed me off even more. Because I didn't even want nobody to know about this. I didn't tell nobody about this. I didn't even talk to myself about this when I got in the car.
What? That nigga said,
you know how you reflect on some shit? I didn't even reflect on it.
My nigga created a mental block.
I turned on the car, bro. I played like some fight music and I went to work.
Hey, can you imagine that? And he a Gemini. He just driving home. He looking in the rearview mirror like, don't even say nothing.
Don't say shit. Don't even say we nothing. Not reflecting on none of that. That is that shit goes in the boundary box, boss. We will not talk about that. I didn't tell anybody.
But I do. I feel like that is the worst feeling ever. Because, I mean, I've said it several times. I have no problem whatsoever fucking a motherfucker once, maybe twice. Because niggas get nerves. We've talked about this. You know, niggas hype shit up. Yeah. DNA can't perform. Okay, I'll give you, you know, another try just to see if, yeah, you know, you come back and show up.
You get the grace. You get the grace try.
Like, yeah,
I've been gifted that, and I had to come back and show out the second time because I failed the first.
But yeah, but
ain't gonna be no third.
It's not. Mm-mm. Like if I have only fucked you twice and didn't come back, and I started being weird and curving, got busy, or you know, I tell you that we go link, but then I never link with you. It's just because I'm not as mean as people think I am.
Right.
People think that I'm just, you know, a horrible person, but I'm really not as mean as a lot of people think I am.
You know what I think it is now? I think with me and you, I don't know about y'all, but I'm not fucking if I'm not getting the sex I like.
Right.
If I'm not getting it how I like it, keep it. I'm not even going to waste my time with you.
See? Especially, and that's especially me now because it's like with me doing OnlyFans, like, I don't want no weak ass sex that I can't post. Like, I have, you know, like they have expectations for things that they're trying to see. Oh. Wait, was that the good one?
Damn, you got to be careful around this motherfucker.
My bad, bro. I didn't mean to do that.
Kayla, stop being messy, baby. Go ahead on.
Like, why she didn't take a chance?
Well, he had already said that, though. It wasn't because the sex was bad. It was because it was a whole lot of women that he wasn't prepared for.
The sex was whack, too.
I'm saying, but that wasn't because we just talked about how you might give somebody another chance.
Right.
But you had already decided. You was like, fuck it, I'm already here.
Fuck, because I was there.
Yeah. And with me,
I had already took a lunch break. Like,
yeah, and it's like with me, you know, it takes a lot for me to be like, all right, you know what? I'll go there.
Right.
Because everybody, like, because there are a lot of guys that are attractive as fuck, but, like, they attitudes and everything suck. So even though they're physically attractive, I'm not attracted to them, and I don't want to fuck them because they're annoying. So when I do find somebody, I'm like, okay, you know, I can work with that, and I decide to give you some ass, and then you don't fucking just knock that shit out the park. I'd be so upset.
You ever been like fucking somebody for like years? Y'all fuck for years, on and off, and then just all of a sudden the sex is whack.
Oh yeah, that was how I got over my ex.
Yeah,
that is how I got up. Like, we had lived together, like we had done everything, you know what I mean? And then just one day we fucked and I was like, that was not it.
Yeah, like I nutted.
I did,
but I had to push that nut out.
I was just like, this is what bitches been coming at me for all summer and the past couple years, and showing up to and starting beef and shit, like all the drama that I had over that. And that last time, that was it. And I didn't go back.
Yeah.
And at that point, I was done with him as a whole. And I was so happy. Like, man, you giving up the measly was probably the best thing that ever happened. I wish you would have gave it up a couple years ago.
Yeah. Damn. Like, when you get some whack sex, it really make you look at a person different.
It does.
Then, like, for me, if you don't suck my dick before we fuck, you're not fucking again. You can go to hell after that.
Yeah, see, and for me, it's like, I can't. We all know that I'm a pervert. Okay. Anybody that knows me or knows anything about me knows that I'm a pervert. But if you coming at me with some real basic shit, like you not putting no effort into it, like, I'm going to be lazy. Just because I'm like, nigga, I'm definitely not finna fuck the shit out of you, and this is what you bringing.
Oh my.
You don't even get that out of me. It's just at the point now that my pussy already out, so we finna get this over with so I can go home.
I'm sitting my pussy out.
And you know, that's why I don't like driving to dick appointments.
Why? You can leave when you want.
Huh?
But you can leave when you want. You made the trip and it's not.
No. I said that wrong. That's why I don't like not driving to dick appointments. Okay. Like, you know, like if we out and, you know, he picked me up or I'm, you know, whatever, like, I would rather just drive myself because then I don't have to worry about that. Because I have definitely, like, while a nigga went, you know, like how you went and took your whole bath, nigga went and, you know, I could hear the sink running. I guess dog was wetting his towel. By that time, nigga, I was in my car. I left. Listen, I went home, got in the shower. He was like, damn, I locked your door.
When I took that whole bath, I was disappointed in me. You hear me? Like, that's.
You didn't get yourself eye contact in the mirror?
I did. I looked at myself like, the fuck is wrong with you? Like, you risked all of that for this? Like, 5 minutes, bro? You might get in trouble for this.
You ever just got up before it was over, though?
Before you've arrived.
Yeah. D, I just said I faked the nut, bro.
Well, he might not have saw that because Tony yeah, had the
here.
Thing on there.
No, he had just got here.
Oh yeah. I faked the nut and got up out of there.
So, for those who just tuned in, you missed it where he got, damn, well.
I got fat fished.
Yeah.
Fat sex and rubbers.
Smell like car tires and lard.
Yeah, I want to smell like, smell like AutoZone and sweat, bro. And I wasn't sweating.
Oh, my.
You know what fucking her was like? You ever like just been moving around on the waterbed?
Like I said, she was just hooting and hollering.
Yeah, it's just hooting, hollering, carrying on. And I'm looking down like, what is you screaming about? I'm not even putting no effort for it.
What is you doing? I hate for somebody to make me fuck lazy.
I was trying to push it. I was trying to push it out of there, but it just wasn't coming. So I was like, no, I'm not finna stay here no longer. So I made a noise. I jumped off it real quick. Snatched it off, wrapped it in a knot. Threw it in the toilet.
You ain't hear that noise? Sound like he licked windows and shit.
Yeah. Like, I ain't even cough after that. Like, telltale sign of me nothing is coughing. If I don't cough, then I ain't nothing.
She said, if I'm not seeing a nigga all the time, I can't suck his dick. I can't. I just cannot even kiss him. See, and my thing is, if I can't suck your dick, we're not fucking. If I feel like I can't put my mouth on you, you can't put your dick in me. Because either way, you touching me. Like, yeah, I don't want you touching me. Period.
Without oral sex, y'all shouldn't fuck anyway.
Yeah, I'm almost 40, bro. I need, you know, so some mouth stimulation.
What?
Like, she ain't no warm up?
Maybe she tug on it or something.
Like, she just get straight to it?
She sound like she just expect the nigga to be hard.
Right.
Like, I've had that happen to me before. Like,
on the jeans.
And the Ocho does, the motherfucker said, get hard. What? Bitch, I'm gonna go get another soda.
Oh,
like,
my.
I'm gonna go get a bowl of grapes. Like, I'm not gonna stay in this room with you. Get it up. She said, get on hard, too. Like, that was the most childish shit ever to me. Get on hard.
Yeah.
Get on up out of here.
But I also have, I have an obsession with oral as well, too. So I do oral more for me than I do for them.
Yeah,
they just benefit from it because I love to do it. I really don't do it for me.
Yeah, I don't eat coochie for them. I eat it for me.
It's like you get that Bryce Leroy glow and shit when you're doing
bro,
it. Like,
especially when I'm getting my shit off. I know I'm glowing. I know I'm starting to glow when I really start feeling myself.
Yeah.
When you start twitching and shaking and shit and calling for God and he ain't coming, yeah, I know I'm glowing in.
They smacking like these mambas.
Yeah.
God damn, nigga, how many you fucking eat?
You know that nigga just don't stop.
I'm fucking paper piled up on the table. Tom Penny that
you
shit.
You don't have diabetes, man.
Go.
He ain't got it, no.
But
he wouldn't keep eating like that. He wouldn't keep eating candy and shit if he had it.
Bro, that nigga just
You have a Mamba graveyard over there.
That's what it look like.
I really don't eat candy, though.
Nigga, you
Did
really
you
do.
Give me a yellow one?
A yellow one?
You want mine? I don't even eat candy.
Disrespect. I'm not supposed to be, but my calories is so low today that it don't even matter.
I only took the shit because he offered it.
Right, like I really.
Yeah, I ain't really do shit.
I'm only eating
I'm probably like
because
at like,
I'm high.
I might be at like 550 for calories.
I just gave the studio a 3-pound bag of fucking Starburst.
I saw that. Yeah, if I'm not having the sex, like I won't, then I don't want to have it.
Oh, I got a question.
What is your question?
Now she's finally here. Keep bringing that up.
Took him a minute, but he got here. He found us.
I got to wait because my mouth juicy as motherfucker. Juicy. Goddamn mama got.
Juicy mouthed it.
Right.
Juicy mouthed it.
I know what I'm going to start using.
My mouth is, pause, is a little wetter than usual too.
Shit gotta be smacking like these.
No, but it, like anybody who's got hair for me, like that was it, like my mouth is like, I don't know why it does that. It's just juicy as fuck. I hate it.
No, it's supposed to be the buzzer. When she do too much, it's the buzzer.
How am I doing too much? The people know why they
any nigga that got some head, got some head for me. No,
no, because it's not dry.
No, I'm sucking the backbone.
Everybody in this room has watched Twitter porn. How many times have we seen a bitch sucking dick on Twitter and it was bone fucking dry?
You know how many times I've seen bone fucking dry in real life? I get it. I just don't want to hear about you on the job. That's all.
It just be sucking dick with cotton mouth, man. What's wrong with y'all?
They just be foul. That's all.
I don't think they'd be enthused about it.
Or they just don't know how to do it. Or they not used to doing it. Or they got some weird fixation.
I'm definitely going to start feeding bitches mambas.
Put it all the way in the back of your throat. Or to juice it up for you.
83 strokes. Boy, what? You Iron Man. I ain't never given a motherfucker that much. 50 and I'm out.
It's definitely, like, I see it all the time on Twitter. And I be like.
It ain't necessarily dry. It's just. It's not a whole lot of slob. Like,
juicy fam.
I need I need slob to be dripping. I need pause. I need my ass to be wet when you suck my dick.
Yeah. And I always tell people like, no, but I would always tell people like, because
no, bro, it's not like that.
You gotta chill.
No, because I would get dudes, and they would try. You know when y'all go places, right? And y'all get frisky out of nowhere,
bro. You ain't. Hold on. Hold it. So you ain't never laid on your back and got some fire head, and when you get up, your ass be wet because the bitch been slobbing for 20 minutes?
I didn't say you was wrong. It was just a little too
Why wet. You hit me with the buzzer then, though?
Because he don't want to hear about you on the job. All
right, that's fair.
Fair enough.
No, but like I would tell people, like, you know, y'all get that thing and y'all pull the front of y'all pants down and the motherfucker pop out like this.
Like a doorstop.
Yeah, and I'm like, bro, your pants will be, we can't get away with that because the entire front of your pants will look like you pissing on yourself. So yeah. We can't do it that way.
Or your drawers.
You gonna have to pull them dick, motherfuckers all the way down around your knees or something.
You pull your dick through the hole and your shit be like all
hit
wet.
Hit the last comment, Tom.
I'm talking about Dino.
Like, see what I'm saying, bro? If I ain't gotta wipe my ass, you really ain't did nothing.
I'm about to go.
I need my booty to be wet when I get up.
So I
y'all ignorant as fuck.
Imagine a bitch hopping in your inbox and just ask you if you like your ass wet.
She didn't say wet, but she did ask me if I wanted my rim job. And I'm like, no, baby, I don't know you.
All right, baby, where were we?
Both. Y'all are fucking despicable.
Yeah, y'all are.
Before bro told us you need pamper change.
Y'all are fucking despicable. I'm just
going to. Sex without hair, you can keep that shit.
I
ain't on that.
That's just. I can't. I don't like boring sex.
Boring sex. Sex.
Like,
you know what?
She's throwing up on dicks out here, though.
Sometimes you can get some boring sex and realize, like, I really could have been playing a game. Or I really could have took a nap. Or I really could have ate my General Tso chicken. Like, it's so much other shit you could have did besides that.
I think. See, that's why I don't like to suck dick with pants on.
Boy, you a freak of leak. For even having red pants on and then risking the head, you knew what you was doing.
I said he went in knowing the risk.
He went in knowing the risk and took it anyway.
I can't. And
give him a hand clap for that. Salute to that man.
And I do shit. And because, you know, like, public shit, it's a rush. Like, you know, it enhances everything that y'all got going on, because y'all already in my, especially if y'all been somewhere and both of y'all been drinking and shit.
Fucking at the firehouse used to be the biggest one.
Why?
Because, you know, you're in the firehouse, at any moment, them tones go off. So you have a choice to make. You gonna keep on fucking until the very last second and have everybody on the truck looking at you funny? Or you gonna tell a bitch, hide in there until we get back? Like, I remember one time I was actually...
Correct answer.
I was jamming at the firehouse and the fire tone went off. And I'm like, oh shit, that's a fire. So I was like, hold on. And she was like, should I leave? And I'm like, it might be a false alarm, so just wait. I'm like, just, you know, lay in my bed. Don't nobody sleep in here but me. We was gone for 4 hours, G. The sun was coming up out that motherfucker by the time I got back. Look at Doug. He trying to make somebody squirt. And then another time, like, you know, It's the risk of getting caught that get you the rush.
Oh, well, yeah.
One of my bosses fucking in the basement. I didn't tell him for 2 weeks.
That you saw him?
Yeah. Like, I was going down there to get something for my mask. We had just came from a run. Apparently, he had this bitch down there already. So, I was going downstairs to get something for my mask, and I heard a faint. I'm like, the fuck is that? And then, like, I hit the bottom of the stairs and see a middle-aged white man with his ass out yamming somebody over a couch. So I just ran back upstairs like, all right, I got it. So in 2 weeks, I said, quite the workout you do downstairs after hours. And, you know, he turned red right away because he knew what I was talking about, but he didn't want everybody else to know what I was talking about. So we talked about it later. He was like, yeah, she just came from the fucking bar and she just had to have it. And I said, did you pop one of your little Viagra's? He said, yeah, it was hard for 36 hours. I said, my God, though.
Oh, my.
He was down there yamming her young ass, too.
No, like, and I've asked, you know, like social media and stuff, different groups, but I've always had an issue with niggas that they always act like King Dingaling. Okay. Like, if they give a bitch some dick, like, that bitch will bribe her own mama for it. Like, they can get bitches to do anything that they want because they fuck bitches so good. Yet,
been there.
These are the same niggas that swear that they can't convince bitches to have threesomes.
You know what? When you finish, I'll speak to this.
And it has always disturbed me because they can either, A, act like they fuck all these bad bitches all the time. Y'all got all these bad bitches on deck, blah, 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 blah. But then when it come time to, you know, recruit motherfuckers for threesomes.
Nigga, are you asleep? Mm-mm. Why are you breathing like that?
That was him?
You snoring. That's why I asked if you were asleep.
No, man. I ain't snoring.
Lay off that Mountain Dew, nigga.
Like, sit up.
Because he done already said he ain't giving none of us CPR.
Bro, that was a joke.
Nah.
It was a joke.
We believed you.
I wouldn't want to see one of y'all die.
You wouldn't, because I already told you. You let me go, what's going to happen. Yeah, you will never enjoy pussy again.
Yeah, I don't want no ghosts.
No hand jobs.
Kicking
no
me in the balls for no reason.
Oh, yeah, you missed that because you was late.
Dude in the airport.
Dog, I was finna say something you made me forget. Oh, the threesome shit. Mm-hmm. Let me know when you finish.
But niggas always got all these bad bitches on deck, blah, 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 blah. But they can never find bad bitches for these threesomes. Or they can never convince all of these bitches that they swear will do anything in the world for them to have these threesomes. They act like they don't know any other women to have these fucking threesomes. But yet, they blame it on the dick being too good for not being able to get a threesome. I've had great dick, and guess what I did?
Shared, I had threesomes with it. You shared it. Right, yeah. Right. Okay. You done?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Because I want you to talk while I eat this candy.
All right. So, most cases I've had, you know, a bitch will say, I'm not gay. I don't like bitches. All right, cool. I respect it. Then you get the bitches that's in their feelings. Oh, I can't see you fucking another bitch. I don't want to see that. That's bullshit, too, because you know you ain't the only bitch I'm fucking, so why not watch it?
Right.
But, you know, they that's their stance. I don't want to see you fucking another girl. And then it goes to, well, it can't be a bitch you already fucked before, because then you going to try to backdoor me. I can backdoor you without the threesome. You backdoored anyway. If we being honest, you already backdoored. So what's the issue? And then it's always the what was another fucking excuse?
My issue be the bitches that they try to bring. And it's like, now you talk to all this shit like you just be fucking all these, you know.
And you know what? Whatever, you always whatever. Have one that's willing and one that ain't. Like, the one that's willing, you'll show her a pic of the one you want to do it with. She's like, oh, yeah, I'll give it a go. But then the one that don't want to do it, no, I don't like girls. And no, I don't want to see you fuck nobody. Like, the cracking.
Well, if you know, now this is my thing. If you know that certain people that you're dealing with not on that, that's completely different. What I'm saying is you can't have all of these types of bitches that you swear will do anything under the sun for you, and you can't even get a threesome out of them. Do you swear that you land down Thor's hammer, and they will sell their firstborn to get some dick from you? I don't buy that.
You know what?
Because I've had amazing fucking dick that I didn't have a problem sharing. It ain't mine. I don't give a fuck. Do what you want
to
do.
I used to have bitches stealing for me. I know I can make them do shit, but they, I don't know. That I'm in my feelings shit. Just, I don't even be wanting to hear that. I don't even want a threesome with you after you say that. Like, the one cracking threesome I had, the girl was in my DMs trying to fuck. And I said, the only way you're going to fuck me is you fuck my bitch.
Well, I don't know why that'd be so hard.
And then
that's literally what I tell niggas.
And then I show her who my bitch was, and she like, okay. And then I tell my bitch, like, look, she trying to fuck me, but I told her, only way she gonna fuck is if she fuck you too. And then they hung out, and you know, we celebrated a few times. But that was like the only time I, you know, I had it work out the way it was supposed to.
But when dudes approach me, that's literally what I tell them. Cause they, well, no, cause you gotta find her. Cause no, you got all these bitches. You got all the y'all got all these bitches until it's time for that. And then all of a sudden, y'all try to act like y'all ain't fucking.
You know what it is? Play with me, niggas. Be thinking they slick telling you to pick the bitch because they don't want to know, they don't want you to know who they already fucking, because the nigga not gonna ask a stranger.
I don't care.
They don't know you don't care.
They do know. I don't give a fuck.
They don't believe you still. Clearly they don't believe you because you tell niggas I don't want to fuck you, and then they text you hello beautiful the next day. So niggas say you pick the girl trying to be slick, not knowing that, bro, you should probably bring in the bitch you already comfortable with.
That's literally, you know what? Go ahead. Keep talking.
I lost my train of thought. You stopped me. But y'all not, okay, ladies, if your man asks you for a threesome and he picked the bitch, he has already fucked her. So you either you going to fuck her too or you ain't, or y'all ain't going to have no threesome. No nigga is asking a stranger for a threesome. No nigga is going out asking a stranger to come home with them. If you let him pick the bitch, he's already fucking her. So if you're going to give him a threesome, give it to him. You know, don't be all weird when it come down to it. Oh, I can't do this or I can't do that or I won't do this or I won't do that. Like, that make the threesome weak too when, oh, I don't eat coochie. What the fuck is we having a threesome for?
That's a good question.
Like, get out. We'll eat some coochie. You get out.
So, I told you, I said, as far as a threesome, I said, I don't know any chick jumping in one blind without knowing who to do this first, which means I'd have to show you to the prospect. Again, that's a potential problem for you. I'm single. I don't have to worry about nobody, you know, knowing who I'm fucking, what I'm doing, or nothing else. Because niggas be saying they single, but they don't really be single.
Right.
Because they don't know how to keep bitches in line.
Just like the creepy folks that they posting on, that they, everybody's so excited about posting today.
So I tell them, like, it's a lot easier for you to pick whoever, because then you can do exactly what the fuck you did to me today. How niggas will come to me like, man, we should do a threesome, we should whatever, whatever, whatever. Well, why the fuck can't, why am I the only person who you can ask that?
Yeah.
But you can't ask nobody else that you fucking, and then just say, hey, both of y'all are on that, so.
But then again, it goes back to people just not being on the same level you on. And then them the people you don't need to do.
Like, bro, because all you have to do is tell whoever that everybody you pick to say, well, I want to have a threesome or whatever. They already know you involved, so you don't have to worry about me picking somebody. And it's like, oh, shit, they know such and such, and I'm fucking with them, too, and they go tell on me. I don't have those problems. Because any nigga that I fuck with knows that they are not the only nigga that I fuck with right now. So I don't have those problems. I don't have anybody to fucking answer to. I don't have nobody that's going to pop up at my house acting a motherfucking fool or how could you, bitch, and all that other. I don't have those problems. Mimi Dinkins is doing whatever the fuck she wants to do with whoever the fuck she wants to do it with, and nobody has any say-so over that. You niggas don't be as player as y'all try to make it seem like y'all are. I am a lot more player than y'all when it comes to these situations. I fuck, I go home, and I don't have to worry about what nobody gonna say about it. Y'all don't have that kind of freedom. I'm sorry for you.
Fatality.
Will y'all stop hitting that button tonight, please?
In honor of Mortal Kombat.
In honor of shit. Yeah, but I don't know. It just, that's always bothered me. Because niggas always act like they can't find somebody. Like, bitch, I am not the only bisexual motherfucker that you know of. For you to be able
to
ask.
It might be, though.
No.
No, maybe.
No.
Okay.
Because it, and the approach that you had, that is exactly what I tell niggas to do. All you have to do is say, look, if you want to fuck, you got to fuck her, too. And then we go get this shit moving.
Oh, that's... That's what
like,
I
like. How is that? How is that hard?
I'm telling you, as soon as that DM went off, like, I said, listen, if you gonna fuck me, you gonna fuck my bitch too. Ain't no way around it. That's the only way it's gonna happen.
I don't understand.
I said,
how
and hard. I said, so how bad do you want to fuck me? She said, well, who's your bitch? I sent her a selfie. She said, what's her name on Twitter? I sent her the name. Then I hit my bitch ASAP. Like, listen, finna DM you. She wanna fuck me, but she can't fuck me without fucking you.
It's that simple.
And they hung out a few times, and then
it's literally that simple. Niggas make it harder.
She just wanted, you know, she wanted to go see how she was, if she was a weirdo or not, and you know, they was both cool. Like, to be honest, the three of us like cool now.
You're like, they don't want to share. Like, that's your fault for picking bitches that don't want to have fun with you.
Dude. Yeah, like, that's dumb. Like,
that's your fault.
I'm not on that either no more. Like,
because that's like me. If I know that I'm into male-female threesomes, if I know that's my thing, what am I going to do? I'm going to fuck with dudes who are on that level who are okay with those kind of arrangements. Yeah. I'm not going to try to get a dude that I know doesn't want to do that and try to convince him or then, well, I don't know, man. I don't know nobody for it. No, I'm going to fuck with people that's on the same shit that I'm on sexually.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
Trying to convince a nigga of that is wild.
No, but I'm just
convince
saying.
A nigga what? To run a train? You don't really have to, really.
Like, I honestly, I have what I call, like, I've named it and we've all agreed. Like, I call them my threesome dream team. Whenever I want to have one, these are the people that I call because we are.
Thank you. I was waiting. Like,
y'all got to remember I'm not just talking to you niggas in this room.
Yeah, but that's who here right now.
Don't matter. Everybody.
Hey,
here
listen.
Right
if
now,
you want to talk about dick and balls at both ends, have you a celebrity guest or something?
I was talking about with the bitch.
Okay, I'll allow it.
Yeah, no, I was talking about with the bitch this time.
Not the one with the booty wind, right? The other one.
she wasn't one of mine. She was
the
there.
Bitch at the
booty wind.
She had to back that ass up wind.
That wasn't mine. Yeah, that wasn't mine. But whenever, like, we always link up and he has amazing dick. I don't try to cuff that nigga. It ain't my dick. I don't care what he, like, we all get tested. We all do what we supposed to do. We all say, like, you know, like, Other than that, I don't care. If you are not bringing some raggedy ass dick that's like, you know, dripping snot and doing whatever the fuck is doing, I really don't give a shit. What?
Who dick dripping snot, bro?
He brought up dick snot the last time he was here.
That's why I said
when
that.
He said
when I got burnt when I was 19. Like, what the fuck? That's not a good thing.
No, he asked me whose dick has snot. I said, you brought up dick snot the last time. You was talking about the kitchen.
Where? How do we get there? How do we get to that?
Oh, because
you was talking about threesome dream teams and Olajuwon and shit.
I said as long as he's not bringing is dick dripping snot and all that kind of shit.
Gotcha.
You know.
Give me the gym.
Yeah.
It does not
hear. Yeah, cause
it is.
The people
you did it already.
They get tested on a regular basis, so I don't have those problems. But yeah, I love my threesome dream team. And he has amazing dick, and neither one of us mind sharing it. Actually, me and her, we be trying to figure out who we go flip next. So that's our thing.
Bro, that's always been a dream of mine. Like, bitch is like, come over here and get flipped on leeway.
Yeah. and you know, and it's funny because it's like, I know what my bitch like.
That's worth burning gas.
Okay.
I'm trying to tell you.
And knowing what my bitch like, I tell dudes, like, when they ask, like, well, why don't you get whatever. Like, first of all, me and her both do OnlyFans. You're not just finna come in this motherfucking just getting a double scoop to pussy and then you're not finna be on this camera.
Right.
So with me,
I mean, you should want to be on camera for that look.
No, but with me knowing that you're not gonna be on that, I'm not even finna waste her time bringing you to her. You know what I'm saying? Like, when me and her do shit, we're doing it for OnlyFans. Like, we fuck around. Like, that's what, when I was at the hotel that weekend.
Oh, she got too high off the wine and shit.
Yeah.
Listen, if somebody tell me I'm finna rock two coochies, record it. Come on, let's. Makeup and everything. Let's get wardrobe together.
They said I'm ready for my close. They said I'm ready for my close up.
Somebody come
here
and frost my motherfucking tips. Let's get this shit together.
Yeah. So when I tell you that, like, oh, well, I don't know nobody. Like, I don't know anybody that's gonna waste their time, and we can't get this content out of it. Because I don't even want to fuck you if I can't get content out of it. So
makes sense.
That's my thing. So while I do have a chick that I always have threesomes with, like, it ain't just gonna be because you horny and you wanna fuck two bitches and you think that we not finna get this money off this shit. It's not how this works. Me and baby girl are on our corn. Her and all that ass.
Baby girl.
Yeah. And it's funny because she randomly sent me some pictures the other day. Because I hadn't talked to her in a couple weeks, like, with everything going on. You know, I kind of been in. But randomly opened my phone and she like, which one you like better? Then it's like, you got bad water pussy and then just random laying on the bed pussy. I picked the water because I don't know what it is about water being sexy.
Soapy titties.
I think it was like the way the bottom of her booty was glistening
like
in the water.
Never wrong with that.
You ever sucked a soapy titty, bro?
Come on, for visual purposes.
Oh, gotcha.
That's still ain't burn the back of your throat.
Yeah, it do. Mm-hmm. Yeah, try to get freaky with some soap going around.
I've been pissed off, like, if a motherfucker didn't wash a cup out all the way good and you pour some juice or something in there and you get that little residue, dog, I was pissed.
I give you the worst ever.
I was mad.
And this is from personal experience. She was a big girl. She wasn't huge, but she was a big girl. She's big at the bottom. I went down on that monkey and she had put baby powder and perfume in that boy.
She gave you dumplings.
Bruh. Dumplings. Knocked my whole motherfucking mouth in the next week. Like, I couldn't even taste nothing. I'm like, what is that?
And so I have a thing. Like, I know one of the dudes I deal with, like, his spot, like, his neck. And one
he
day
put
I was
cologne
drunk.
On that boy, didn't he?
Man, that mother
tingling.
And you know, it makes
it lock your mouth up right away. Like,
fucked me up for a minute.
Like, I was sucking titties and shit, and I went down, big old belly button she had, and I'm licking gunkums and rolls and everything else.
Gunkums.
Fatality.
I got down to her
coochie. Push that button one more motherfucking time. I'm really going to see a fatality in here.
Duh, I got down to her coochie and my whole tongue locked up.
It hits you I back. Asked, remember when Martin used to do like this? Yeah, like, it's just like that.
I said, what's this down here? I put baby powder on. Wow. I said, that ain't just powder though. What else? Perfume. I said, why? What you covering up? Like, what's going on down here? I'm like, turn on the light. Let me see. And that was like the end of our interaction. Cause you not just finna dry my mouth out like this. Like, no, bitch, I don't need to deal with shit like this.
Yeah, that's doing too much.
Yeah, bro.
Like I said,
perfumes and powders.
I know that cologne taste, and I was like, oh my god,
it'll ruin it.
And it don't go right away either.
Mm-mm.
Like it lingers.
And if you drink water, it make it worse.
Yep. Now I'm mad thinking about it.
Yeah, I was pissed.
I mean, that shit smelled good as a motherfucker, and but I guess I didn't think about it because I was horny and I had all that liquor and shit, and I was just in mode.
Bro, this is another one I kind of risked it for because she lived on like 50th and Center. I done already drove over to Chirac. Mm-mm. And you putting baby powder and perfume on your snatch?
Nope.
Yeah, you won't get to see me no more.
She was trying to be fresh.
Nah. I mean, if you just watched
it. What you see when the light came on? It looked like a wet
just
powder
a big
donut.
Old just a big old pussy with powder on it.
It looked like a big ghost.
It's like
a donut.
She had to listen. I'm finna be funny for a minute. So I assume when I text her outside, she took her drawers, shot the powder down there, and fluffed it. Because when I turned the light on, the inside of her thighs and shit looked ashy, but I realized that was the powder on it. The powder had settled.
I mean, had you like slapped her on the ass, you probably would have knew because that little.
But again, it was dark. She used to keep the lights off because she was a big girl. She's a little self-conscious. Like, that was the first time I really made her turn the light on. Like, turn the light on. Let me see.
That powder ain't sweet.
Baby powder is quite disgusting.
Did you keep sucking them or not, Sierra?
Probably.
I just it don't cake up when it get wet.
Powder? It do.
That's what I'm saying.
I stopped putting powder on my nuts when I was 13.
Uh-uh.
Cause it really don't benefit you, nigga. You gonna sweat or you ain't. Stop eating ham. You'll stop sweating.
Nigga, the ham was covered in the powder.
Right.
Quit eating pork and shit. You wouldn't be sweating all about your motherfucking genitals, man.
Yeah, I don't. I think that was like, was that the worst?
I tell you what,
powdered ham.
When a bitch throw powder on her shit and it started to clump up, that shit looked like BV. And you really got to get out of it. You don't know what it is. It's just time for you to go.
But that's what I asked. Like, when it get wet, it don't, like, cake up. Like,
yeah, look like piece of dough down there.
Grand's biscuit.
And she didn't already spray the perfume and covering it up. Like,
so you really can't trust
her. Yeah. I damn near went to the gas station and drank some gas to burn that shit out of my mouth. Because I didn't know what she had going on.
That is fucking horrible, man. Like, in as much as I can appreciate clean dick because you should have clean dick.
Fresh balls.
Mm-hmm.
I hate when I'm like, I don't think he had it in the rinse cycle long enough.
And soap's still on it.
Yeah. Like, yeah. You know, you go there and it's like.
it's like. When you lick
soap
a,
scum
when
on
you,
his dick. Yeah, niggas is wild.
Spots from the dishwasher?
You know, and it makes me think like, well, maybe, you know, I don't think he put it, you know, in a full wash cycle. He must have tried to wrench it
off. Or he ain't
have
enough steam in there. Motherfuckers don't shower with their water hot enough either.
Nah, nigga, I melt my skin off.
Yeah,
most women do.
I'm damn near trying to be red when I jump out the shower.
Exactly. See, most women do.
I don't give a fuck.
But
I bet I be clean
like, with the super hot water.
Nah, but
motherfucker ain't never said my dick stinks, so I'm good.
And you know, like, and that's another thing, like, it's not, it doesn't stink, but it's like a dick smell. Like, it just, it smell like dick, but it's not a.
Hey, remember when Star told Jerry his breath smelled like dick?
What was that, before or after he said something about licking his own neck?
That was before he was before. Jacking off and eating it.
Okay.
That was before that.
Self-explanatory then.
Yeah. But yeah, she told him his breath smelled like dick at the Halloween party.
Yeah, but it's like, it's not a, it's musty. It smell like a dick. And
can you stop saying that?
No, because I don't know how to fucking describe it other than it's like.
Was it bad?
No, it's just because it's not just a single dick smell. It's like
multiple dicks.
Is this nigga pH balance off or something? Like, what is you trying to tell us?
He dropped his trial and he had a dick win.
Like soap and salt.
See, salt and vinegar.
It's like I could be sitting
Chef
here right
salty
now.
Balls. Ow! Yeah, duh, don't
man, you know what? Everybody got their own scent, so maybe that's what it is.
What? But that's what I'm saying. It's not just an individual. Like, it's dick. Like, I really can't find another way to say it.
Can you stop saying dick? Penis, maybe? Say
that
penis.
Don't make it no better.
No,
I can't describe it. But like I said, it's
say
not it's not something that it don't, you know, it don't turn your lip up and shit like, ugh, nigga, you need to go wash that. It's just it's dick, bro. I can't put it no other way.
This chick I fucked with years ago, her coochie used to smell like ammonia.
That's not healthy, bro.
That is pure piss.
something wrong with her.
Like, she wasn't wiping. She was shaking
like,
it off.
What the fuck? She was young too. Like
she got urinary.
We was young, so maybe that's what it was. Because I'm like, what did you clean this motherfucker with? That it smelled like ammonia. You know the ammonia you used to clean the house with. Like, that's what you should smell like.
Darn, sis, that's not like pine salt. Yeah.
I wasn't eating coochie at that time, so
well,
I ain't give a shit.
It might depend on how country your family is, because you know a lot of motherfuckers like that bleach
that?
Water in there.
Hmm?
Bleach
you
in the bathroom.
I said I was young,
was
man.
Okay. You good?
Yeah, bitch. I only been burnt once, and she wasn't the one that did it.
You got no superpowers?
I might. I can make a bitch believe anything. Maybe that's my superpower.
Are you the Sorcerer Supreme?
Maybe.
You a sorceress. That's nigga.
I've been enchantress from Suicide Squad. Mm-hmm.
Casting spells.
You know, we was just talking about how motherfuckers don't be attractive after the first time you fuck. I done made you believe I care what you're going through just so I can fuck.
Been there.
Might be my superpower.
You might be a terrible nigga.
I don't have to.
Like, you really like an anxious person.
Right.
I used to be.
That has to be exhausting.
Now I'm not even going to entertain it because I know y'all not going to give me the kind of fucking wit I want. So, it don't matter now.
That is so hard, not getting fucked the way that you, like, when you walk into that situation with, you know,
high expectations
of how things are gonna go, and then you leave and you like, so okay, so there's like a catch 22 to it. Like, I hate being picked up and then getting dick, because not only was it not what I wanted, but now I have to ride in the car with you.
Yeah.
On the way back.
So you look at him with disgust the whole
time? I don't
time?
Look at him at all. I'm looking out the window. I'm looking at trees and street signs and that dog pissing on the hydrant. I'm looking at everything but this nigga.
That bum so taking the shit behind the building.
So you doing the scene when the little kid be moving away from their childhood home?
Yes.
Just looking ew, sad.
Glue? Yikes.
What the fuck smell like glue? What did I miss?
The balls with the powder on it, I guess.
Oh, my God.
Hey, when you peel glue off your hand, that's terrible.
Yeah.
But
I know if I don't get my dick sucked, the sex ain't going on.
But
I'm
going
to get you done in 9 minutes.
But then when I drive, I'm mad because now I done wasted my gas. And y'all know how much I hate driving. So now, especially if it's late, I could have been at home, comfortable, in bed. And don't let the weather be a little bit fucked up. Well, now I'm really mad.
Right.
Because it's cold outside or it's raining. It's some kind of shit where I could have been at home and you had me out here in the elements for this weak ass dick. That's why I don't like fucking new people.
I don't even entertain the flirting though. I don't.
Nope. And that's me. Because like, I shut it. I don't.
I know now. Like, nah, you ain't willing to go that far. So no.
Yeah, motherfuckers hit you with a random.
Like I didn't already see motherfuckers already turning nose up to get their mouth spit in, and I've been doing this shit since. Mama. Can you?
How did she find us?
She been on here.
Can you block my mama, please? Like, what the fuck? I didn't share it on purpose.
I don't know. She's been here the last couple weeks.
Anyway, I mean, she know the type of nigga she raised. So, I done already seen motherfuckers say they don't want to get their mouth spit in. I've been doing this shit since 2012. Like, you don't like your mouth spit in, grow the fuck up. Or leave me be. Like, just don't play with me, period. Because that's what I'm going to do. First go. Open your mouth. That's it.
See, mine will be forceful.
Mine ain't forceful. It's
more of a sensual kind of, like, mine not forceful.
You spit that aggressively?
It's quick. It's quick and a kiss after it. Like, I ain't going to make you feel like a dog after it.
Right, like, you are a baby bird,
mama. Your show not on? Like,
this is her show.
What show? It's Monday, nigga. Ain't no TV. Wait,
this is her show.
We all.
She said what with all the question marks?
As long as it was for you and not me.
Maybe she taking notes.
Oh my dog.
The
fuck is wrong with you, man?
You gotta chill, fam.
Nah.
Hey,
that's
be
the
mine.
Wrong comment, boss.
Mama gotta have a life too, bro.
No, that'd be don't. Mine.
Nah. My mama don't even bring niggas around me.
The things that my mom has asked me to show her, it's ridiculous.
She tell niggas right away, my son.
I damn near need to show her so she can help pay some bills around this motherfucker.
She always say, my son don't play that shit. I can't bring you around my son.
Nah, that's disgusting.
Yeah, that is. You disgusting.
I got it. That's why I want to know how the student surpassed the master at this point. Why is she asking me to teach her?
You know what? Sometimes I be thinking like,
knees work.
I be doing shit and thinking like, how nasty was my daddy? Like, there's no way I just came up with this shit I be doing. But then I don't know. I'm scared to ask mom, so I don't. Like,
I'm hoping she don't pop up and answer it on the screen.
She you know what?
Right.
For my birthday, bro, we was listening to Old School and Cooking and all this shit. And I think, come go with me, Teddy P start playing. She said, this how your daddy got me. I was so disgusted on my birthday at that. Yeah, this how your daddy got.
This I how hope you, that's not.
This how you got here.
That's fucking disgusting.
Like, come on. And that's probably some slick shit dog said, too. Because I would have said it. Come on, go with me.
Ain't it a Teddy Pendergrass look?
Right, yeah. She said I was made to that song. Nigga, are you listening? I don't even listen to the song no more.
It's enough of your origin story, fam. Huh? It's enough of your origin story.
Don't be mad at me because the condom broke and you came. Accident.
Hey, look, I done told y'all several times. Moms was definitely in the abortion clinic, ass out, jet mag, waiting to go. So,
for who?
For me.
How did you get here then?
Oh, my fighter. Daddy came in there begging and shit. Please don't kill my baby.
Really?
Begged and shit.
I thought you bit the end of the hook off.
Nope. So I'm like, you act like you did me a favor, motherfucker. I got these bills because of you.
Right. You ever had a cable bill on your
like,
name?
Like you?
When
no.
You was
actually,
a kid?
No. Actually, you know, honestly, I haven't had like the ghetto upbringing that a lot of my friends have had and experiences and shit that my cousins and all that shit. I actually skipped out on a lot of that. The most hood thing about me was that I was hitting bitches in the mouth all the time. Everything else. I didn't really deal with.
I stayed fighting when I was little.
Yeah, that was it. That's why even
you
to this day.
Cable bill in your name as a child?
Yeah.
Nope.
Cable or phone, one of the two. I want to say it was cable, though.
Interesting.
Yeah. Nope, I never
you
had.
You was born in the '80s. You was likely to have a cable bill in your name. It was easy to do back then,
can't
I suppose.
Relate, brother.
All right. Were you born in the '80s?
88.
No, that don't count. No, I'm talking 82, 83.
No, bro. Can't relate.
Hmm?
Can't relate.
Nah. You all right.
Yeah, I didn't
know. I lived
know.
A sheltered life, bro.
You did? That's not a bad thing. Like, I'm not shaming you for that.
Like, I was terribly, terribly, terribly spoiled. And I wouldn't call it really bougie, but I was a kid, like, if I went to your house, like, I had my bag, I was supposed to be spending the night or something. Nigga, if I see a bug, I'm out.
Yeah.
If I get there and you ain't got the kind of cereal I eat, like, what the fuck? Kix, Ma, can you come get me? Like, now, there was nothing wrong with Kix. It was just, it didn't have no fruity flavors or nothing. Like, it was, I wanted variety. So, I was definitely that kid where if I went and I felt like the conditions weren't, you know, equal to or better than home, I wanted to go back home.
Listen,
you're not wrong.
At 13, my people decided, let him go spend 2 weeks with his daddy and his brother. The third day, I was calling my grandmama to come get me. I knew she was in Atlanta at the Olympics. She worked the Olympics. So I knew she was there. I called her like, Mama, can you please come get me? She's like, what's wrong? I said, I don't want to be here. She said, why? I said, they don't have what I got at home. I'm ready to go.
Yeah.
She said, well, baby, you know, I'm in Atlanta. I'm not at home. I said, I know, but it'll be all right if you just come get me. Then I called my granddad, like, can you, like, turn around and come back? Like, can you come get me out this nigga house? I don't want to be here.
Yeah, but that was definitely, you know, me. And it wasn't in a sense where I looked down on anybody. Like, I've never done that. I wanted to be where I was comfortable. Like, bro, I don't want to eat hot dogs all day long. I want to go home and be able to have a, you know, variety and assortment of snacks and Kool-Aid and shit. Like, we got Kool-Aid at home. I don't like Flavor-Aid.
Yeah,
like,
I can sit in the living room and watch the TV by myself. I don't have to watch it with my brother.
Yeah.
And whoop his ass because I don't want to watch what he want to watch.
Yeah. So that was something that, you know, I can say that I am definitely blessed and grateful for. Like, I did not have a lot of the struggles that a lot of people around me did. But my house was also the hot spot. Everybody always wanted to be at our house. So we was always moving in, my cousins or my friends and motherfuckers from school and shit. Like, we had real life, like, guy on the couch moments and shit. We're like, go down in the basement.
You don't know who the fuck is at your house.
Like, homeboys just down, like, sleep in the basement shit on the couch and shit. Like, because they didn't go home. And then it was kind of fucked up thinking back. Like, damn, like, bro, your parents didn't even...
No, nobody cared.
Try to
where
find
they were.
You to know that you ain't been home in like 6 days. Like,
that's a wild reality though.
But they probably talked to your mom, but then like, yeah, he alive.
No,
it wasn't none of that. Oh.
But my mom, like, she was, my mom was never the, like, she wasn't go put no kid out on the street. Right. Like, if she, you know, like, if they felt safe,
it was kind of like
the house,
they knew
and we
which...
always had more than enough for everybody, so we always took everybody in at my house. That's what's so funny about some of my cousins showing the ass the way that they do now. Like, bitch, no. You was always at my house because you didn't fucking have nothing. And now you want to sit here, try to speak ill on my mama's name? Man, you better suck a dick.
It's kind of like if they knew which kids you're usually with, then they just figure, like, oh, that's where he at. Yeah. I was always at the house on the corner. They always knew I was at Prince's house. So nobody never really came looking for me.
And then the neighborhood kids. First thing. Now, the neighborhood kids, like, not the kids from school, but, like, the actual kids in the neighborhood, like, now their parents knew. Were to come, like, they knock on the door, like, hey, you know, is Mo here, or is it whatever. Oh, yeah, you know, they're upstairs. And I'm sorry, all right, well, you know, let them know, time to come home, whatever. But everybody was, my mom was the neighborhood mom and shit. Like, she was just, everybody, even to this day, how am I doing? Like, she was always mom to everybody.
Yeah, so. Everybody still asks me about my mama, too. Like, I see niggas I grew up with, they be like, how your mama doing? Like, she good.
Yeah. So, all of you niggas that grew up with me and came and, you know, ate the food, slept, and all that shit. Come get around my fucking house. It's y'all turn now.
That's wild. That is a wild request.
I am passing the buck. It is on you. All you niggas wanted to mom. Well, goddamn it, come be a son or a daughter now. Goddamn it.
Hey, listen.
I need my space. I'm trying to fuck.
I saw
God damn. Yikes. I saw a post earlier.
Buzz all you want to. That's what the fuck I be doing. Because she fucking there.
It says, I'm trying to get to it. Pardon me. It's taking longer.
If we could use both eyes, it'd go faster.
If a girl has a boy. Shut the fuck
oh,
up.
Oh, you heard man. Me?
Yeah, bitch. If a girl,
oh, wait, you can't see.
If a girl has a boyfriend and she fucks a girl, is that cheating?
No. If, because there's an if that is their agreement. If you are in a relationship,
no, that's not the question. That's not the question I just asked you. If she has a boyfriend and she fucks a girl, is it cheating? I didn't say if they have an agreement.
No, because that's really what it is. Cheating is what your partner feels it like. Even if you don't have sex with somebody, but if your partner feels like, oh, well, I kissed this motherfucker goodbye or some shit, bitch, you cheated on me, like, because that's the boundaries of y'all relationship, then that's what it is. Some dudes are just as jealous of women as they are of men. Other niggas don't care because they're like, well, shit, a nigga ain't fucking her, so they don't care. So cheating is really defined by y'all relationship and what y'all terms and agreements are, because everybody don't look at everything the same.
I don't think it's cheating. As long as you don't hide it from me, it ain't cheating.
But that's what I'm
saying.
If she's not hiding it from you, then I've y'all seen, have an agreement on
I saw niggas say, yeah. Like, I saw plenty of niggas be like, yeah, it is. I mean, like.
But that's to them.
It's a bitch. Like, if she, as long as she don't lie about it, I don't give a fuck.
Because see, that's y'all arrangement, which is what she just said. So whatever y'all agreement.
So I'm agreeing with her. Like, I give my opinion too? Or was it just for her?
No, because you didn't agree, motherfucker. You told me that I was wrong.
No, because you. No, I didn't say you were wrong.
You did. You said that's not what I asked you. You clearly said that.
It's not what I asked her.
You said, is it cheating?
I'm not even talking to you.
But I'm. Motherfucker, I'm sitting here listening. The fuck you think? Because I'm high, I turn my brain off? It works better.
Yeah, I do. I do.
It works a little bit better. Because you are really not making any sense right now.
I seen a lot of niggas like, nah, my bitch can't do that. My bitch can't. Boy, you tripping.
He not tripping. He don't want his bitch fucking nobody else. It's a common request. It's called monogamy, motherfucker.
Like another, it's a ding ding or something. It's just,
called monogamy.
Well, because a lot of guys may feel, okay.
I guess they feel like they might lose their bitch to another bitch or something.
Well, maybe not even that, but it's like, okay, but I'm not finna go off and fuck another dude to make it even. I can't go fuck a bitch, so why can you fuck a bitch?
Right. That's the exact point.
So you have somebody else, but I can't have somebody else, so that's cheating.
Imagine
but other
a
people,
nigga really going the extra.
So I ain't going to fuck no bitch, but I'm going to go ahead and let him talk.
I'm going to show ahead and go grab this nigga's balls. Like, what the fuck, nigga? Sit down somewhere, man.
No, but I
at
don't.
At that point, it's not even. You're gay now.
Right.
So you have lost.
You just sucked the old dick trying to prove your girl wrong.
But that is not
terrible.
You know, you can't define that with like just a concrete general answer. It literally goes based off of your relationship and how your partner feels. Because for some people, you don't even have to physically engage with somebody else. You staying up late, having intimate conversations, texting the same motherfucker all the time, and you hiding it from them, you're cheating on them.
Yeah, I think anything you can't tell your partner's cheating.
Right. So, you know, you can't really ask, well, is it cheating? You can say, well, is that cheating to you? But you can't fully define that as cheating because some people don't care. They're like, well, shit, I'm cool with that. Because I've had a lot of guys who have been like, dude, like, I don't even want to join in. Like, I just want to be able to watch you with another woman.
Yeah.
And I'm good being able to watch.
That's kind of where I am with it. I don't necessarily need to join. I'll sit back and watch.
Yeah. So them being able to sit there, you know, and live in color and shit and just watch it and be there, that's enough. Niggas sit there and stroke it in the corner and shit. I wonder if she got that move for me type shit.
Right. If my chally is required, I'll definitely get right necking and jump in. But I would love to just
sit, I just pictured Jim Carrey to.
You know it. You know somebody, I'm taking all my shit off ASAP. All at the same time. Everything coming off.
So, okay. So we'll go around the room. So, would you be okay if your girl had a girlfriend? She'd be like, where are we?
I guess it's all right.
Now, you can't have nobody, but she got her girlfriend. So you can't go out and be like,
you can't
oh, well,
you go out
get,
you can't go out and get your dick sucked. But she getting her pussy bumped and ate on whenever she feel like it, when you ain't around.
Oh, no, that's not fair now.
Now, is it because it's not fair, or that's just something you not with, period? Is it because you can't do it, too?
At this point, it's not fair. This is not an even trade.
All right. I get it.
Lucky?
Nah.
No, you ain't with that.
Now, I mean, I'm cool with it, but like the same thing was. Right, it's a one sided deal.
You know what? I see it as.
It is just, it's the one sided.
It is deal. Not even like that you just want to go out and do it. You just but it's just like, hey, you know what?
You don't have the option.
Bae's out right. of town. I get it. And I'm at Popeyes, and this bitch is down the street. Maybe I want my dick sucked right
now. Yeah, I want her bitch to be our bitch. That's all I
and
have.
Nah, yeah, I don't even. That's how I see it, though. Like, I had this conversation earlier, and I said, if you have a bitch, then we got a bitch. It's the only way it works.
Yeah, that's the only thing. If that's the case,
now if
sure.
y'all are fucking the same bitch, that's cool too.
Yeah, that's the way yeah. I gotta have it.
Oh well, yeah. Then now we just have a girl.
If y'all
yeah.
doing some separate shit, then you know
somebody's gonna bring something.
I see y'all when I see y'all. You know what I'm saying? Stay safe.
Yeah, and like I don't know. I really strongly feel that it has to be something that you are communicating with your partner. Yeah. So for women, I don't want you to just automatically assume that because it's a girl, it's okay and he won't or shouldn't have a problem with it. Because at the end of the day, if he can't have his own bitch or, you know, whatever on the side, you can't be too upset if he like, well,
think,
bitch, how you getting the,
I think
you know,
Kevin Gates and his wife got something like that.
How you go sit here and get all like, this ass and I can't get some ass?
They have all these threesomes, but she can smash females whenever the fuck she feel like it. But he can't. Allegedly. In theory. He's not supposed to.
He didn't got in trouble and wrote songs about it.
Now,
so
if,
right. it.
Now, if they have a thing where it's like they're still doing stuff together, then that's probably what kind of takes the, okay, well, I don't care. Because we still no. are fucking bitches together. But I don't know.
Yeah,
like,
she
I'm
don't,
not a.
For some reason, she don't want him knocking another bitch without her knowing. I mean, I can respect that. Like,
but I mean, that's like even with.
Controlling the bag.
Don't bring lobsters home.
But that's like with my situation. You know, with me dealing with people like with doing the OnlyFans thing, like, I clearly know that, you know, y'all fucking with other people. We all are. It is what it is. So I'm not trying to, you know, plant my flag on none of you niggas. But I don't understand what's so hard about just being upfront and honest about that when y'all not together. Like, why is that so hard when you know that a bitch is not yours, a nigga is not yours, you not his, you know, you not hers, whatever the case may be. Like, why is it so hard? And it's usually the motherfuckers who swear. They swear that they don't give a fuck what nobody think, what nobody got to say. Oh, I ain't hard up for no pussy, man. Pussy come a dime a dozen, blah, 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 blah. But yet you are doing all of this to keep this pussy around. Well, if pussy is a dime a dozen, then why is you working so hard and hiding so much shit in order to keep this pussy on your team? Pussy dime a dozen, right? Go get you some more then.
Another dozen.
Yeah. Like, but that's why I say, like, I feel like I'm a lot more player than niggas are. Because I can do that, and my niggas know that they're not the only motherfuckers that I'm fucking with. And
I think it's easier for females to move like that, though. Like, niggas really not gonna care. Females are gonna care. They gotta feel like they the top bitch. They gotta feel like they Alvin, and the rest of the bitches are the chipmunks.
You know what's funny? It's actually because I've learned, like, because of the way that I move, like, a lot of dudes don't like the way that I move. They just had the option. Either you go deal with it or
they don't even have to deal with you on a daily basis. How can they not like that?
But
because she's the alpha in the situation.
It's because I don't react to situations like the typical bitch would. Mm. Because of the fact that I move the way I move. So you know that I got somebody else. And I'm not going to be up your ass chasing you. I have no problem not talking to you. I have no problem with, oh, that was it. Bye.
Why do...
And I don't have those issues.
Why do people need to talk and see you all the time? What is that?
I think it's more of an ego thing. It's not even because they genuinely want to talk to you all the time. They don't want to hear about your day. They don't care about what's going on in your life. Motherfuckers just want to feel like you are on their dicks, literally. I feel like that's what it is.
I don't like...
They want the attention because somebody made them feel like they were that nigga or that bitch.
I don't like the I want to see you all the time shit. Like, I don't... like a lot of days...
I like solitude.
Yeah, a lot of days I just want to be by myself. I don't want to talk. I don't want to see nobody. I don't want to hear shit. I just want to be the fuck by myself. Like, I want to be left alone. Like, and I'm not the type of nigga that's going to open a text message and see, come see me right now and actually do it. Like, no, you got me fucked up. I'm not finna move. I've never been the type of person to move on somebody else's time. I'm gonna move on my own. And if you don't like that, then, you know.
I have my moments. Because I'm like, ooh, yeah, I'm behind on content anyway. Mm, so. The amount of money that I make off of that, I don't do it for them.
I don't like it. I've never been the up under me type of person. Like, I don't need you up under me all the time. That shit's weird to me. And maybe because, I don't know, if I was like just by myself so long. That's why. But when a person want to spend too much time with me, it give me a weird vibe and I kind of back off.
I don't even think it's people like wanting to spend time. Like
it ain't said, spend time. It's just you want to make sure I'm not fucking with nobody else, basically.
Oh, no, not me. Like, I
know not you.
I've literally told niggas, like, look, what you do before I get here, that's your business.
What you do after.
What you do after I leave, that's your business. But while I'm here, my time is my time. I don't need my shit interrupted because I'm on a mission. I'm trying to do some shit. Other than that, I don't give a fuck what you do. I'm not finna sit here, be calling your phone, where you at, what you doing, who you with. That ain't my business, bro. I done clocked out. I'm gone. I'm on something else. Like, that's not, I don't care. And I feel like that bothers a lot of people, like, because they feel like they don't like to be treated like how they treat us. But it's not like I'm treating them like that way to get back at them for treating women that way.
That's just
how I am. Yeah. And I've always been that way in that little period of time where I tried to, you know, do the relationship thing and try to, you know, have motherfuckers living with me and try to be the lovey-dovey. Oh, you know, the marriage, the kids, the blah, 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 blah. Yay, so in love. Like, that's just, I know why that didn't work. That's not who I am. That's not who I'm into.
Yeah, I'm not the be up under me type.
I'm here to play, not to stay.
Come on, man. You got to be quicker on them buttons than that, bro.
Hey, how about you be on time next
that
time?
That was a gym, fam. How did you even miss that?
Yeah, the same way you was 30 minutes late. How'd you miss that?
She said 8:30. I got here 8:37.
Did you?
Yeah. Yeah.
Really? Nah, I don't believe you.
You going to give her the gym or no? Ass. I didn't ask for all that back and forth.
So ineffective now.
Yeah, he fucked it up, didn't he?
He's forced at this point.
What the fuck?
So, okay, so one thing that I want to talk about before we get out of here, because I feel like it's really, really important for me anyway, just because of, you know, how I talked about, like, how I grew up. So, did y'all see the post about Ocho Cinco and his daughter?
Yeah.
Mm-mm. I saw it.
Huh?
I read it after you posted it.
Okay, so long story short, to catch you up, his daughter wanted some Yeezys.
Shoes?
Yeah.
Okay.
And he was saying, like, well, you know, you said you was going to get a job, you was going whatever.
How old is his daughter?
So,
it's like
she's a teenager.
16.
She's okay. A teenager. 17.
All right.
Working age.
That's a fair age.
But people are dragging him for him making his daughter work and get a job because, you know, he got all this money. And I feel like these are the same motherfuckers who will sit up here and complain all the time about how social media influencers and the card, like how motherfuckers be famous and getting all this money for not doing shit.
He wants her to get a job.
Yeah.
Did he say, no, I'm not going to get them?
No, he said, if you want these shoes,
get a job.
You got to get a job.
I think he's teaching her just how to take care of herself.
Right.
When she gets older.
Facts.
I don't. If he didn't
like,
say
there is
no.
absolutely nothing wrong with building a work ethic in your kids. Just because you are famous and you have money and you are a celebrity does not mean that you shouldn't put a work ethic in
that's
your
kids. Part of the problem.
Who didn't leave a son the money? Jackie Chan. Is he the one that didn't leave his son the money?
Yeah, he
because he wants that nigga
to
earn
charities
it?
Or something.
Yeah,
and he's. I believe the quote was, "If he can't, you know, use his talent, do whatever to make the money on his own, then when I'm gone, he ain't gonna do nothing but waste mine.
Yeah, waste my money,
and something like that. But my mom gave me everything that I wanted. Everything I needed and shit that I didn't even need, just, you know, because that's how she was. You know, I've talked about that several times. My mom was the materialistic type, you know, when it came to me. So any and everything under the sun, I had it. But at that same time, she has always drilled in me how important it was to have a strong work ethic, how important it was to be able to work for the things that you really wanted. Even with all of this shit that my mom did, once I was of age, I had a shoe habit, an expensive shoe habit.
Man,
she so,
wasn't cheap no more.
Yeah, so her thing was, she like, okay, well, you know, you want, you like all these shoes or whatever. You buy your shoes. She was still buying my shirts, my pants, my electronics, paying my phone. Like, she was still doing all this shit. The only thing I had to do was buy my shoes. And I felt like that was fair because of how many shoes I used to get at that point, but it was at the same time, like, I have cousins that grew up getting everything, but they're also lazy. They don't know how to get money now. They don't know how to do anything except for the easy way.
Mm-hmm.
They don't know how to work. They don't know how to grind. They don't know how to, you know, really, really get shit the way that they're supposed to get it. Because everything that they got, their mom didn't work for it. It was scheming and scamming for everything. You know what I mean? Like, they didn't see her getting up. Like, it was totally different. So even though we all had everything we wanted growing up, we had two totally different upbringings because my mom always, always put in me the importance of working hard. So even now, all these years later, do you know how many times I could have gave up and not bust my ass the way that I did just because I ended up being a felon? But I powered through that because I wasn't finna let nobody tell me that I couldn't work and do what I needed to do to be able to provide for my family.
Right.
And now look.
That's one of the issues I've always had with my cousin Carlos, because my mom would literally make me and my sisters have to do everything. Meanwhile, this nigga can just come and go as he please. Now to this day, this nigga can't keep a job because he's self-sabotaging. Always looking for everybody to help. And even went and got a white woman so he don't have to do shit.
Yeah. Those be the motherfuckers, like, they always have to be bailed out.
Answer this problem.
No, for real. He was finna fail out of school because he didn't want to take responsibility. And it wasn't until he met some dumb white chick and they made him go to school when he was living up there with them that he even graduated out of high school.
Yeah, because, like, okay, even with my granny. Like, my granny did a ton of shit for my mom. But the reason why she did so much for my mom was because my mom was doing so much for herself.
Right.
So motherfuckers would look at her like, well, why are you doing this or helping her get this car, or, you know, giving her the house or doing this or doing that when we the ones that need it? Well, you need it because you're not fucking working for it. She's doing everything that she has to do. So this is the one that I'm going to reward for her hard work because she's busting her ass to do everything that she needs to do. So, yeah, I don't know, because even with the girls, like, obviously, you know, I'm trying to do something and build something that I can leave, you know, for my kids to be able to benefit for years to come. But at the same time, they're not going to be raised to be lazy and entitled to the point where they feel like everything is supposed to be fucking handed to them.
Boy, Chief didn't white play dude. That shit at all.
You not going to get everything handed to you.
Bro, almost ruined Great America for me because I didn't cut the grass the day before.
Woo. Carlos done got so many consoles fucked up.
Bro, JBZ come to pick me up that morning. We supposed to go to Great America, right? Chief come right in the living room. He said, I should be an asshole.
and tell you you can't go because you didn't cut the grass yesterday when you got out of school. Bro, I almost, like, exploded at that moment because I had my fit and everything ready to go. And, like, my grandma kind of looked at me. She kind of, like, looked it off. Like, she looked it off to let me know he was playing, but he was trying to make a point. She was like, I was like, whew, thank God. And then Jay Beezy was looking like, so who the fuck gonna ride down there with me? Like, I'm like, we good, bro. He just, you know, he just making a point right now. Like, I should have handled what the fuck I was supposed to do. So, like, from that point on, I always took care of what the fuck I was supposed to take care of before I went off and fucked off, pretty much. Like, yeah. Dude was tough, but he made sure, you know, we learned how to take care of shit the way we supposed to.
Because that's like even now, like, Ree has been chomping at the bit for a job. And it's not that I don't want her to work. It's finding a place that I feel like is suitable for her to work.
Culver's.
See, and that's the thing.
I think Ree might be too sarcastic for Culver's.
Yeah, I can't see Ree working like a fast food spot.
No, because I'll be on the news.
Yeah, like, Ree is so, she's so witty. And she would say shit to people to make herself laugh.
Like, the attitude from her
is not even to get people to laugh at that person. It's to amuse herself. Like, she's so smart that she would be amusing herself all day.
She has my problem. You know how sometimes we be talking and I sting y'all, but I really didn't mean to sting y'all. It just came off.
Yeah.
Then I'm like, damn, bro, my bad. Like, you know, right. I could have saved that for a day you was fucking with me, but unfortunately, you know.
It came out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, it's been days I've been like, yeah, you cooking with gas today. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to chill out. Because I can tell when, you know, all cylinders are firing. And I'll leave it be because I ain't got time to come up with comebacks. So I just, like, man, fuck it.
Yeah, but I want her to be able to, you know, do something that is not going to stress her out so early, especially because at this point, while she wants to work, and I do want her to get that sense of responsibility, even now she's taking on the commissions and stuff for artwork, you know, so she does have, you know, her hustle going. But as far as like with throwing her in the workforce, I don't want it to be like typical Black households where when you get to that point, you feel like you're obligated to, you know, help out and stuff. Now, Beans, that's my baby. That's my little sweetheart. And she's always trying to help out with stuff or, well, Ma, I can pay for this or I can, you know, I make her keep her money. Them kids be loaded, okay? Between Marv mom doing, you know, stuff and like, yeah, like, yeah, them niggas
she
be.
She probably got a whole college tuition tucked under her mattress.
Yeah, and then her great grandma in Georgia, her dad's grandma, she sends her stuff all the time. Because she'll even send money for real. And you know how old people, they still write checks. So she send them checks and I just mobile deposit them all. So just leave them there, cash app her. Yeah, because Ree, that nigga definitely got at least, I think she got about 4 figures in her fucking, her cash app from all, because Ree's cheap. I love that about her though. Because for her to be a teenager, Ree is 16. One thing, that nigga will not let money burn a hole in her pocket.
Libby don't either.
Like, reach here. Mom, we should go to Culver's or we should get some Chinese food. You got money. Never mind. And then they go in there and make a burger or some shit.
But that usually comes from parents who instill what money means.
Yeah.
You know, like, being the fact that they have access to money. May not be as much or when they want to, but they have access to it. They're not in a rush to go spend it.
Yeah.
Libby is that, like, and she's,
my kids aren't material. They're nothing like I was as a kid. They're not materialistic, so they answer real, real simple shit. Like I told y'all a million times, Reed asked for fucking boxer briefs for Christmas, bro. I asked her if she wanted the fucking PS5. She was like, "Why the PS4 still work?"
Boy, money.
I asked Libby if she wanted the X Series. She was like, "No, my Xbox still working."
Yeah,
money burner. Like, all right, bro.
Yep, she ain't been asking for no phone up because Reed still got what, her Note 8. She like, it worked. I don't even need, like.
All Libby care about is anime. And phone cases. That's it. Yeah. She like different phone cases.
If I didn't think your dog would eat beans, I'd drop her off. Cause
she into that.
That's all she fucking do.
My girls are into that shit now.
That's all she do. Like, anybody with access to Monte's HBO app will see fucking anime everywhere. It's my fucking kids.
Bro, Libby got me paying for Crunchyroll and some other fucking app.
BRV. Either that or Funimation.
Funimation. That's the one. Yeah. Funimation and Crunchyroll.
That's all. My kids are really, really, really into Asian culture, which is why I don't understand why Ree fought me so hard Libby on Asian
to,
grandbaby.
She wants to.
Your reasoning was
she wants to learn how to speak Japanese.
Ooh.
She need to be around.
How old is she?
14.
Ooh, it might be too late for her.
No.
No, because Japanese is hard from what I heard.
No, them girls, they sat there and they been teaching themselves.
She only watched the shit with the
subtitles.
Yeah. The shit don't be in English for real. Like, I was sitting there watching. They was like, ping, pang, 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 ping, pang.
You be watching that sub.
I was like, what?
That's the subs, not the dubs.
Yeah.
Right. But they are so into, like, because Ree wants to go to, she is obsessed with, like, getting to Japan. And so I'm saving up. So 18th birthday, that's my plan to.
There's an anime store in Houston. And I said I was going to go get Libby some shit out of there. I saw it. And forgot to go back in there, but it's complete anime shit. Like, they had a big ass Goku looking nigga in the window.
We used to have a model zone here. I don't know where the hell it went.
Yeah,
it's where the Atomic Tattoos is now.
Yeah. Well, on a final note, I just want to say that I'm upset because I wanted to see a lot more blood, guts, and assholes being blown to smithereens on Mortal Kombat.
I think they
but
gave us a teaser, and they're going to make a better sequel. I got faith in that.
No, it's not that.
It's going to be a trilogy, though.
It's not, like, it wasn't a horrible, just, oh, my God, what did I just watch? Because it was funny. Like, it was entertaining.
Yeah.
I'm just, like, for me, the video game itself was, it looked more advanced than the camera work in the movie.
Like, the story, I think, actually, in the video games were more in depth.
Like, I think that's what really got me. Like, now, we are in 2021, and we got these realistic-ass video games, but then this movie looked like it belonged on the Blockbuster video show.
I feel like they rushed it a bit. They could have. They could have just rushed it, trying to get some shit.
Up the production team.
I wanted to see, you know, when you hit a nigga on Mortal Kombat, and it showed the break going all the way down their back and shit. Like, I wanted to see that in the movie.
Oh, you wanted to see
they went the back to the old finishing moves. Jax clapping the motherfucker head, smashing it. Like, Shang Tsung had a bad wig.
I wanted more violence.
I hated his whole outfit.
The whole, hit him, period.
His,
like,
whole concept.
They could have left Buddy out.
Nah, you kind of need him for the first one.
Nah, bro. The snitch from Batman? Y'all couldn't think of no other tie-dye nigga to play Shang Tsung?
That is racist, bro.
What?
That's racist.
What's racist?
Hey, I will say this.
You just called him a tie-dye nigga.
Is his eyes not tight, nigga?
Hey, I will say this. The Han and Behind must have stood for hoe-ass niggas because that's how he treated everybody.
Everybody. He had smoke. He had smoke for everybody
he
in the movie.
On business.
Even before, like he had the real shit going on.
That nigga approached the throne and was like, hey, it ain't even going to be no tournament. Out. Killed that nigga ages ago.
Yeah.
Still.
I don't even know why we here.
I don't like that.
Cook.
But Scorpion couldn't speak English, but he could say, get over here. Like, y'all couldn't have him say one English word prior to that, so I could believe it.
Well, I guess my thing was, like, you know.
And then it wasn't even his voice. It was, over here.
Yeah,
it was the video game.
You could have just hit me with the actual voiceover of the nigga from, like, 92.
Well,
I actually expected nigga to pop out in the corner and Tootsie. I actually expected that.
Well, y'all know that I watch everything with subtitles. So I thought it was funny because it's like Chinese, Japanese.
Did you notice that too?
Yeah. And then,
the languages
but he
was
told
switching?
Him, that nigga said, I don't know what you said, but I'm going to kill your shit.
Sub-Zero is Chinese and Scorpion is Japanese.
Yeah.
It's like, you motherfuckers got a big ass language gap. How y'all really talking to each other?
Yeah.
I guess some words match.
No, like he didn't say one English word, and then all of a sudden, the part we all been waiting for, get over here.
Like, but, oh, so he learned it
while he was in hell or what?
Yeah, pretty much.
So, my, I think the best part of the movie was Ree's reactions.
Melina's ass.
Because for one,
big bun.
And we didn't see it. So
it's actually not big though.
No. So the thing
it was the angle from when she was walking toward the mountaintop. I was like, oh man, she got some cheeks.
So first thing Ree said, she was like, well, I'm finna go research Melina's character. No, she was like, I'm finna go look up who plays Melina for research purposes. I already knew it was because she's the gay.
Yeah, she's with the golden fat.
Bro.
That's what she just said.
But that's not what I said.
That's definitely nowhere near what she said.
I said because
she's the please, hit him again. Hit him with the sit your dumb ass down.
Man, sit your dumb ass down.
That's what I was looking for. But it was the reaction.
What's wrong with you, nigga?
But it was the reactions to little shit. Like when he took Jack's arms, right? And, you know, just kind of kicked the nigga like, fuck it. And then
when Jax hit the
yeah, nah, but Sonya texted him like, Jax, where are you? And Ree bust out laughing because he couldn't take back that nigga that had no arms. I'm like, bro, who raised this fucking child, man?
Fuck you.
Like, she was, that shit was hilarious.
Why did Jax hit like another level before he fell all the way to the bottom? Like, he hit that other level hard.
Yes.
It was like
it reminded me of when
it like a pinball falling.
It honestly, it reminded me of Endgame when Thor was holding the star open and fell.
Yeah.
And he thought he was gonna catch that nigga with the pod and shit, Rocket did, and then that nigga said ding and he hit and rolled hard.
Yeah.
But
it's all around though. It wasn't a terrible movie.
I don't know why Jax chose to kill fucking dog. He tried to shoot him and he froze the entire gun. After that, I'm out.
I would have took the fuck off after that.
Right, like I don't.
He tried to hit him with some ghetto shit after that, and that shit didn't work.
Six tours, motherfucker.
We definitely laughed at them little arms, because it was like
when they had him land on the table.
Well, it was
or the little metal arms,
the thin arms.
When Kano sat at the dinner table and told folks, "Hey, you give me an egg roll," and he called him something.
He said top knot. That's what started it when he called him top knot.
Yeah, you give me an egg roll.
No. Yeah, but you know, it wasn't something that I entirely hated. I'm just,
it wasn't bad.
I like violence.
Why you just wanted more?
And because
of it.
Mortal Kombat, what is Mortal Kombat? It's fucking violence. Like, the whole shit is built off of fatalities and shit.
I think we'll get more violence in the next movie.
And it just, it looked like it was recorded. Just, it didn't look like it was a 2021 film.
No, it didn't.
Like, references, yes. But as far as, like, just the quality of the movie itself,
they didn't have to make
with
it so
graphics
dark.
And the, like, the capability. That you know what? I know what it is.
Like?
I know what it is.
You know what? I feel like
I'm spoiled by Marvel movies. That's what it is. I'm used to the epic graphics and shit of a Marvel movie. That's my problem.
And Marvel also put the $1 billion behind.
I know, but
Mortal
I'm saying
Kombat
I just because after waiting so long,
I
expected
though.
It to your look better on screen.
Right, your anticipations was, and then you got.
I didn't mind how it looked though. For what it was.
Kano fucked up the force field or whatever. Tie-dye folks with the perm came through the hole. Like, the little stage they was on, I was like, man, this look weak. Like, location was fucked up in this movie. I don't think they had enough locations.
I think the location was affected because of COVID, honestly.
Yeah, it's gotta be COVID.
They could have waited. We waited all this time.
Yeah, it's been, what, 20 years?
Hey, they didn't have to leave that Cabal line in the movie either. But it was funny. I'm glad they did.
Oh, yeah. And he's about to get his soul sucked.
He's like, hey, he about to get his soul. How he looked at him. He was like, hey, he about to get his soul sucked.
Yeah, then got this nigga groaning in the background and shit.
Yeah. Oh.
That That was the sound you made with the biggin.
Yes.
We are on our way out of here. So people are hitting me for the freak nasty stuff. I will not be delivering tonight because it is 10:30 and I would have to go home, get products, and then come back. And I'm not gonna do that. But I want to thank you guys for tuning in for this week's episode. I want to thank you for showing up eventually.
Appreciate you.
So if you were not able to catch the full show live today, you are always welcome to stream every single Tuesday on all of your favorite streaming platforms such as Apple, Spotify, Amazon, YouTube. We are all over the fucking map. And Mother's Day is coming up. So I want you guys to be on the lookout because I will have Mother's Day baskets. So Commerce Candy Closet will be. Just in case your mama might want this 12-inch anaconda safari mode.
Cut it. Hit the button, nigga. What is you doing?
Say we go, Mimi.
No, I'm not. So this is the 12-inch anaconda from Safari Mode Ultra Skin. Okay, Doc Johnson Ultra Skin is fucking amazing. It feels so good in the pussy. Okay,